looks almost identical. But that's where we're headed here, right? And that, like I said, these guys are exactly the same. They have the same form. The only way they can have the same form is if they have the same differential equation. Okay? So let's sort of like do, just, I'll show you one step, and then I'm going to move on very, very quickly. So one of the things here that we'll do here is that we do the following thing here. So when I look at my first step here, I want to determine IL of 0 minus. And how do we determine IL of 0 minus? Well, we let the inductor go to a short. And what you're seeing here is that it kills off the 3 ohm resistor. And I'm left with these two resistors in the circuit. So what you'll find here is that you get this guy here, which is Vs. And then I'm going to get a 1, a 2. And then I'm going to have the 3 here. And then my inductor here is a short, right? I L of 0 minus is a short, and that kills off that resistor. So I could come in here and I could calculate I L 0 minus then has to be, I only have one loop, and that loop tells me that it has to be Vs divided by R1 plus R2. So the next thing that we want to do here is that we want to convert this into a Norton circuit here. So if I come in here, and now I want to convert this into a Norton circuit, what we do then is that I now throw the switch. As I throw the switch, it kills resistor R1. So I'm left with R2 and R3. So when you look at this circuit here, that means at t equal to 0 plus, we saw that the switch is thrown. And so now my circuit looks like this here. I get 2, 3, and then in this case here, I have an inductor. So this is R2, this is R3, and this is an inductor here. So what we typically do now in this case is we do what? We convert this into a Norton circuit here, and we do the following thing. So now, to convert that, I'm going to remove load. And so then I have a circuit, so then I'm going to determine I short circuit. So if I determine I short circuit here, I'm going to get Vs, then I'm going to get R2, R3, and then what I'm going to do here is that where the load was, I'm going to put a short there. So I'm going to put a short here, and that short is I short circuit, and you can see right away that resistor R3 is gone, and this is R2, so you can see that I short circuit has to be V source over R2. So I got I short circuit. And in a very analogous way, I could come in here and I can determine R Norton here. And if I calculate R Norton here, I'm going to take my circuit. And what do? I remove the load, the source here. And so what I have here is that I have a current that looks like a resistance that's going to look like this. So this is R3, R2, and then when I look at this guy, this will be Rn. And you can see that these two resistors are what? In parallel. Because they're in parallel, that means then Rn is the same as R2 parallel to R3, which is R2, R3, the sum of R2, R3. And then we would then go in and calculate our time constant here. And when we determine our time constant, what we'll see here is that if you want to determine, you know, 1 over tau, tau is L over R naught. Okay? So if that's the case here, then I'm going to go in here, and you can see that 1 over tau will then be Rn over RL. And then I would then come in, and I would stick that into my solution here. And so then our very next step here, and 3 here, is that then we put into solution form. And if I was to put this into solution form here, I'm going to write then that my I short circuit, and of course we calculated this guy here, I would then just put in my values for and then I would solve my circuit problem from here. So I'm going to use the exact same techniques, just like we did before. The question is, why can I use those exact same techniques? Because the differential equation must be the same. So we can derive the first order equation using the Norton form. So if I start off with my circuit here, and the Norton form here, we have I short circuit Rn, and then I have my inductor here. So according to this here, we have a very nice circuit that we can solve here for I L of t here. Now because I have an inductor and that current is changing as a function of time, you can see that there's really only one node, right? We can say that the bottom node is a ground, and then this is the only unknown node. And that node must be the voltage across the inductor, which must be the voltage across this resistor, which must be the voltage across this source here. So, but since there's only one node that I got to consider here, so I'm going to use KCL. So if I use KCL, it must be the current across the resistor plus the current across the inductor. However, the current across the resistor is the voltage of the inductor divided by the current across, divided by the resistance Rn. And if you remember, there's also this inductor equation, which looks like this here. So I got to put all of these values into this equation here. And if you look at what you have here, you end up getting something like this here. So I got VL, so I got VL over Rn plus IL. And then this guy's then going to be L over RTH di dt plus I equals I short circuit. So if I take this equation and I redraw it, so it looks like this, where I divide the value L over R both sides, you're going to see here that I'm going to get a value of L over RTH over 1 IL, which is equal to I short circuit L over RTH. Now if I define dummy variables like I did before, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to define X to be what? IL of T. I'm going to let tau equals L over RTH. And then I'm going to set my K value to be I short circuit over tau. So when I do that, I get the equation that reads dx dt plus x over tau equals k. And this is the exact same form of the first order equation that we got last time. So this tells me here that the solution of t must be the solution at infinity, at its initial value, like this. So I get the exact same form. Everything works exactly the same. So I put quotes over there when I said exactly. What we're really switching here is that we're doing what? We're switching x for the current of the inductor, and the time constant is different, right? Tau is now L over RTH. It's not RC, but everything else works exactly the same. So that being said, I think we should go to the next circuit, okay? So what I want to do here is I want to go to example 8.3. So I'm going to erase here in the middle. Let me give you some minutes to look at that, okay? Get some minutes here. And use them wisely.
Thank you. Once it's switched, the zero, the current source will be shorted. And then the current through that will be 0.25, meaning. And then it's gonna still go through the point. Yeah, same strategy.
Hey, let's go here. Let's look at this circuit. So remember, you gotta have the same kind of thinking that you do with capacitors. So the question is this: is the current of the inductor increasing or decreasing when the switch is thrown? Okay, don't all talk at the same time now. Okay?
That's true.
Okay, let's look at that. So one of the things that you'll see here is that this guy is open, so there's nothing here. So what I'm seeing here is that when this switch, so note the switch is a very strange switch here, right? You get arcing. So what I did here is I drew it a little bit different. So this guy's always in contact with something. And then when it finally slids onto the second switch completely, then that current source isn't being like shorted out like that. So what you're seeing here is that I have 500 milliamps coming in here. As I come over here, now note this whole branch is gone. So this guy is now going to get what? 500 milliamps. Because it kills off these two resistors when it goes to a short. Now, the switch is thrown, it disconnects this. This is 500 milliamps for a brief moment, and then this switch is here. That voltage source is going to produce a current. But one of the things that you'll see here is that by itself, it had all of the current coming from the current source. But now, with this 100 volt source here, as the current comes in here, you can see that it's going to be divided here. So it's having to share the current. So therefore, I would expect it to decrease. So I'm expecting the current to decay. So what we're saying here is that we expect that at IL 0 minus, we saw that we have 500 milliamps with the switch thrown, the inductor has to share the current with the resistor 0.6K. So we expect that there's a decay in current. But that's what our picture's telling us. That's what we expect. That being said here, let's go calculate. We want to calculate this voltage here, but for us to calculate this voltage, we've got to calculate this current. Now, no, I don't know why I put an arrow there. I didn't have to. Which direction is the current? Well, it has to be this way. This is gone. This is where that's at right there. So let's go through the steps here now. By the way, just to step back here, and let me test you here. I have the inductor. It's going to look like this here. So this is sort of like a little test here. IL of T has to be I short circuit plus or minus the value, absolute value of this guy. What is the sign here? What does plus mean? It's decaying. Right? So that plus tells me that I'm going to get a drop in current from 500 milliamps to whatever it is. So I expect a plus sign. If you don't get a plus sign, you're doing something incorrect. Go back and fix it. Okay? Here we go. So let's go through the steps here. So the first thing that I'm going to do here is that I'm going to look at step one, and I want to determine VC, IL 0 minus. Okay? That's the first thing I want to do. So how do I do that? Well, the first thing here is that note that this is completely gone. So if I look at my circuit here, I have my short here, and then I have my 500 milliamp source here. And you can see that this is my current here. And what we can see here is that this guy, because it's a short, kills off this whole branch. So right away, we could come in here and just say, you're gone, you're gone. So therefore, I only have a single loop. So I could then write IL 0 minus 500 milliamps. Okay? So I have my current. So now, I got to take my circuit here. When the switch is thrown, this current source goes away, and I now have only this part of the circuit here. So step two here, so the switches are thrown, and then I calculate Norton parameters. That means I short circuit Rn, and I want 1 over tau, where tau is equal to L over RTH. Right? That's what I'm after right there. So here I go. What am I going to do? I have my circuit now. What does my circuit look like? It goes like this. So it's 100 volts plus or minus. I have a 0.4K, I have a 0.6K, then I have 0.4K, and then I have my inductor right here. Right, so here's my load right here. So this is A, B, and I want this current right here. Right, that's what I want. So what am I gonna do? I'm going to remove the load, and then I'm going to solve for those things here. So here we go. So I want to determine I short circuit. So remember, remove load. So if I remove the load here, I'm going to replace that load with my short. So then I'm going to go 100 volts. I'm going to get 0.4K. I got 0.6K, then I get 0.4K, and then I have my short here. Right? Then I have my short. So what you're seeing here is that I want this current right there. Now, look at the circuit here. The current I short circuit has to be the current through the 0.4K resistor. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to say, I want the current through that K resistor. Now note, I have that guy right there too, right? So you got to be careful which 0.4K resistor. But I'm assuming that's obvious which one we're talking about, right? If you're not finding that obvious, you're not looking at the circuit. Look at it again. So how am I going to do this? Well, there's a bunch of ways that we could do this. I could do a source transformation here if I wanted to. I wouldn't do that, dude. Use voltage divider rule, right? I get the voltage of the 0.4K, and then I divide that by 0.4K to get the current. So what I'm going to do here is that I'm going to use VDR to get voltage of 0.4K, and then I'm going to use Ohm's law to get I 0.4K current here. So Let's do that here. So if I do that, it's going to look something like this here. So here I go. So VDR. So if I use VDR here, you can see that I got this guy in series with these two guys in parallel. So when I look at that, if I want the voltage across the 0.4K, it's got to be the drop across these two in parallel, which will be 0.6 times 0.4. Ooh, that is not pretty. Let me write this one more time. So it's 0.6 parallel to 0.4 divided by 0.6 parallel to 0.4 plus 0.4, and then multiply this guy by 100 volts. Okay. If you do that, I end up getting 37.5 volts. Okay? So now I got my voltage. If I got my voltage now, I could go get my current. So now I'm going to use Ohm's law. Ohm's law then says that the 0.4K resistor must be what? 37.5 divided by 0.4K, which then will give me milliamps, and I get a current of 93.8 milliamps for I short circuit. So now I have my I short circuit on the window. So I determine I short circuit. So what am I going to go after next?
R Thevenin
or R Norton. So if I look at my circuit, what am I doing? I remove the load, and then what do? I put place a short at the voltage source here. So then what I'm going to do now here is I'm going to determine Rn. So if I look at that, I short the voltage source, then I get this. So when I look at this guy here, I now have this is my Rm. So if you follow the current, you can see that this is really almost the exact same circuit as before. Current comes in through here, and then it splits right here at the corner, telling you that these guys must be in parallel. So then this guy reads 0.4 plus 0.4 parallel to 0.6. And I get a value of, for R Thevenin, of 0.64 kiloohms, or 640 ohms, for R Norton. So then the last parameter I got to calculate is 1 over tau. So now I want to determine 1 over tau, which is what? L over RTH. Oops, maybe I should call it, I don't care what I call it. RN over L. So I'm really calculating the value RN over L. So here I go. So 1 over tau is RN over L. So what is L here? L is 0.1. Okay. So this is 0.1. And then Rn, I'm going to use the 640. So I'm going to get 640. So this gives me 6400 hertz for 1 over tau. Okay, so I got my three Norton parameters. Now I just put it into solution form. So my next step here is I want to put into solution form. And the solution is ILT, I short circuit, plus I.